I'm Micah Smith, and I'm a developer evangelist here at Automation Anywhere. And think of this session as almost like the prequel to the other Tech Track sessions. We're going to be getting ready to get hands-on, so we want to make sure that if you want to participate in some of the hands-on tutorials, if you want to run some of the demos where we share the code, we want to make sure that you have a machine that is capable of running these different bots, capable of participating in some of the labs that we're going to do. So this is all about getting your machine set up if you don't have a machine set up already. So let's jump right in. First off, this is really a three component thing, right? First, we're going to make sure that we're registered for Community Edition. If you already have an enterprise environment set up, or you already have an enterprise account, or you already have a Community Edition account, you can skip this part. But the next part is going to be setting up our bot agent. So once we've got our registration taken care of, once we have our login credentials, once we have our control room, things like that, we're going to log in. We're going to add a device to our account, and that's when we're going to install the bot agent. Again, if you have Enterprise Edition or you've already set this up in Community Edition, you don't need this part, but we're going to do this together just to make sure that everyone understands exactly how to set their machine up, how to get registered, and how to make sure things are working. The last part of this is we're going to do some validation, and we're just going to create a really simple bot with a single message box on it that just allows us to run and make sure that we've tested our installation, tested to make sure that our bot is going to work, and tested to make sure that communication between our bot agent, or what's running on our local machine, and the control room is all good, okay? So if you've already got an account set up, you don't necessarily need this video if you've been doing bot builds before. But if you're brand new to this, I would encourage you to hang with me here. We're gonna jump onto a virtual machine and set all this stuff up. Now, the first thing we're gonna have to do is register for Community Edition. And I have the link of this in the description or in the text below. But this is at automationanywhere.com/products/enterprise/Community Edition. And Community Edition is the free edition of Automation Anywhere. And it allows you to build bots. It allows you to run bots on your own, completely free of charge. Now, when you go through and set this up and register, it may ask you if you want to do the trial edition instead of the community edition. Just leave it at community edition, okay? Make sure that you select community edition so you can get that login credentials. The trial environment is only good for 30 days. The community edition you can log into later. So once you've got that set up, you will get an email that looks very much like this one. And it's gonna say, hey, thanks for signing up for community edition. Here's your control room URL. Here's your username, which is the same as the email that you registered with. And here is a temporary password for you. Now, once you go through and click this, make sure to copy off your password. It will ask you to do just a really brief registration. And basically you just fill in your username, your temporary password. It will ask you to fill in a new, not temporary password so that you can actually do your login. And that's when you're gonna like basically be taken to what I'm doing right now. So I'm doing. Going to log in and say all right, so that's my login. Let me hit login here. Okay, so my login is complete, and because this is the first time I'm logging in to this account on this machine, it's saying, hey, can we give you some help in getting things set up? You can choose to go through this if you want. For the purposes of this video, I'm gonna hit no thanks, and we're gonna set it up manually. So the first thing we need to do is click on the My Devices tab over here on the left-hand side. And notice that I don't have any devices added. If you had a device added already, that means you've set this up before, so you know, you'll obviously know what you did. But because we don't have a device added, what I'm gonna do is hit this plus sign right here next to the computer that says Connect Local Device. And when I click that, it's going to start to establish a connection between my machine and the control room. So I'm gonna hit connect to my computer, and it's gonna automatically download the bot agent for me. Now, to save time for this video, I've already downloaded that bot agent, and so I'm gonna go through with the installation. So it'll download the bot agent for you. When that bot agent has been fully downloaded, you can just double click it, and that will kick off the installation process for the bot agent. So that process is kicking off, and it's extracting an MSI. And there's really not much to this. It's gonna ask me one question. It's gonna say, do you wanna install this for all users or just the current user? I'm gonna select all users, and It will require administrator privileges, I believe. There we go. So I'm going to say yes here. And then it's going to complete that installation for me. You could alternatively install it for just your user. It would not require administrative privileges in that case. So we'll let that installation finish. Great. So I'm going to hit finish here. And notice that it's already recognized that my bot agent has been installed. It's also going to try and install a Chrome extension for me. So I'm going to hit I enabled it. And then I'm going to click this Get Automation Anywhere extension. You may see that it pops up and prompts you to install this. For me, I'm just going to click that button to install it manually. So I'm going to hit Add to Chrome. And I will hit Add Extension. And then I can close this out. And what I'll do is click this little icon here. I'm just going to pin it just so we see that it's there. There we go. And now it's establishing a connection to the control room from my local device. And when the two of those are in sync, that will allow me, as I'm doing my testing and as I'm running actual bots, that will allow the control room to send those tasks to my local machine. For a nickname, you can optionally give this. I'm just going to say, imagine getting started, and hit done. Cool. So it has my machine name here. It has my device nickname. I have some information about the bot agent, stuff like that. The other thing I'm going to need to do is up here in the top right corner, I'm going to click on this icon, and it's going to ask me for my device credentials. And this is for my local device. So this isn't the credentials that I use to log into the control room. This is like what I use to log into Windows. And so for me, that is this. So I'll hit update. Cool. And now those credentials have been applied and it's able to communicate with my machine. So the last thing we need to do is validate that installation. So I'm going to go up here to bots and my bots. And yours is going to look just like this. You'll just have a single folder that has sample bots as its name. I'm going to click this icon right here that says create a bot. And let's just call this one, imagine, spell that right, setup validation, hit create and edit. Cool. So if you're totally new to this, we do have a session on getting started with bot building. So, you know, they'll go through a lot of what this layout is and things like that. But what we're going to do here on the left-hand side is just drag down till we find message box. And we will click the little caret next to that. And I'm going to drag this message box action right over here. Notice on the right-hand side, it gives me some properties that I can set. I'm going to say it's working and then hit save. Okay, so I've built my first bot. All it is a message box that will pop up and say it's working. I'm going to hit this run button here. And at this point, what's happening is the control room is going to send instructions to my local machine for this bot to execute. And it's going to make sure that my local machine has everything that it needs to be able to run that. And then I should see a little window pop up in the bottom right hand corner where the bot has actually started its execution. So at this point, it's syncing the local dependencies that are needed for this message box, and then we'll start to run. That syncing of local dependencies will only run the first time when a new package is being used. It wouldn't happen like that every single time. Great. So I have a pop-up here that says it's working. I now know that my local machine is connected to the control room. I have my development environment set up correctly. And I'm now able to participate in any labs or demos or anything like that. Hopefully this helped you to get things set up. I'm really excited about Imagine. We've got a lot of really great sessions on day one and two, and especially on day three, we've got some tech tracks where you can get hands-on, do some tutorials, see some demos, download and run code. Super excited to see you there. I'm Micah Smith. Go be great.